Milhouse, pretty good hero. Now, this is the worst possible Milhouse lobby because there's no elementals and pirates, which both are amazing tribes with the hero. And we have this very interesting triple on turn one. So try and pause the video and figure out how you would take this, because there's a lot of different ways that you could. And this will be how I do it. So you sell the main body and try and triple the token, which, you know, if you don't know by now why you do that, I'll link again to the video. And this video, we might or might not get rewarded for that play as well. So clearly illustrating why you go with this line. Now, here we hit a hyena. It also depends, I guess, on your next upcoming shops, how you take this triple and what you do. But generally, I don't think taking a triple here is ever worth it, since we now have 3 1-1s on the board with this hyena, which is stronger than playing the alley cat here and only having 2 1-1s on the board, if I would keep the 2-2 triple token in my hand, if that makes sense. This turn, I guess I'm just buying bacon, selling a level, since I do want to keep my pair on the alley cat still as well, which is the main reason we sold, you know, the main body, so that way we could have an extra triple. Now this turn, very often you can just triple buy, but I decide to just go for the 4-drop. I just sell the hyena, again, not the alley cat, because it's still a pair that I would value keeping on the board, so we lose a little bit of tempo, but we generate the triple. Now these are fine, I guess. Tank is some decent tempo. I do have 2 gems, so we could take Shaker, although, you know, we don't have a setup for any of that yet. So I just go with tank, I'll be strong, and then maybe I can consider leveling next turn. Or just getting, like, a super strong board on tier 3, because it's still only turn 4. Keep in mind, next turn is turn 5, that's why most people just level 2 tier 3. Well, we already have a tank and could have an amazing board here. And guess what? We will, because there's a deflector bot, another tier 3 Culbor, which is amazing. I could just buy out the entire shop, honestly, and still have another pair on the board. Now, at the start, I said this is a bad Milhouse lobby, because there is no elementals and pirates, meaning there's no gambler, so that is literally just free money, because I can buy salad. There's no hogger. Hogger with Milhouse is amazing. And there is no recycling rave, no major domo, no nomi. Basically, Milhouse likes cycling because you can buy things for cheap, just 2 gold, so everything costs 1 gold. So a lot of comms that cycle or that you just need to buy and sell a bunch of stuff are obviously amazing. So that's why I think this is also an interesting game to look at, because usually Milhouse in these lobbies is pretty bad. We do find some max though. Max is good. Now, not really as Milhouse, because you can't roll a whole lot and max need to hit specific cards. So that's why I'm gonna play just a bunch of tempo stuff this game. I just try to be strong and I'm kind of playing for top 4 and see how I can transition into an actual late game build. So that's why I kept the pair. We do hit the triple eventually, which is amazing. Now you could consider taking a 6-drop here, but because there is a module in the shop and because mackerel would be an insane hit here, I'm going for that mackerel. But if I go for a 6, I would have to double sell as well. Like, do I really sell my beast and my Culbor? That's a decision I'm unsure of. And we're also facing Shadowwalk, who is going to be pretty strong. So I think I'm fine taking a 5-drop here. Agam is, you know, maybe consideration, so is Crocolisk. But I'll just take Tempo. I'll take this Battle Master, since there is Soul Devourer in the lobby, which is free. So Soul Devourer, more than free, it makes you money, because it costs 2, and if you eat something, you gain 3 gold, so you gain +1 gold as Milhouse. Just a big body, and, you know, Menagerie, yeah, I can take a Jug now as well, you know, I can be relatively strong. I have a pair on Leaper, which I kind of want to keep, so I have to module my Leaper here. I'll just end on second Leaper, and maybe at some point I can hit that triple. So I'm pretty strong, you know, it's turn 7, I got a big Deflector Bot, a Battle Master, a Tank, and another Divine Shield Taunt. That is a pair, giving us more potential. The main way we can transition out is if we hit Menagerie pieces, which is pretty unlikely, I guess, since, you know, you would need to high roll a lot and hit a lot of different pieces. Or if we triple into a Mega Buster, go full max, maybe hit Mackerel. Grease bots are not that great anymore, so maybe Orm and find more taunts. We'll see what Bob or Venari in this case has to offer. We can take every buff because it's 1 gold. Once again, we're Milhouse, so that's why I took Battle Master. We can just take most of the things that are useful. There's another module as well, and an arm, so that instantly just rings a bell in my head of, okay, we can just be like an arm taunt comp and be strong that way. Now here, I think it's best moduling the tank, because I'm not getting tank value anyway. I don't really have any death rattles on the board. It rarely shoots, and it's already high attack mech. Late game as well, the value falls off. You don't really value or care about like 5 damage to your opponent's board. Unless it's a Golem tank with a heavy Death Rattle Avenge board, then it's great. But in this case, it's not, so I'd rather just use it as a big body that I can module and scale the attack up. There's a Soul Devourer, there's another arm, so it seems like we figured out what we're doing. Also, by the way, if I played my module onto the other Leaper, if I triple Leaper, it's kind of a waste, you know? The, combining two Divine Shields in one is generally not that great of an idea. And find a Menace, so finally we have a reset for this Deflecto that we haven't had a reset for yet. And there is a Golem, I guess, which I could go for and give up on the Sleeper pair, which I do end up doing. I have to give up on it anyway soon, and I might as well, since I'm 13 HP, I'm pretty low, this lobby is very grindy, and I'm up against the top guy. So I'd way rather just, you know, go kind of all in here, have an extra reset maybe, and, you know, double arm. We got some great scaling, so one or two units. We did beat him, which is great, and now maybe I will level, because tier 4, you know, I hit a lot of good stuff already. The only real thing I can hit is like triple arm, but then I want to go into a Sig Shop, because right now the best thing to hit would still be Buster. Buster is a great way to scale this comp, and we hit Kangors and then maybe Baron, and you know, that seems like the best future for now. I do have passive scaling anyway, and here's a module. Now I could module my mech, but it is so hard. Like, I don't see how I do it. I would have to sell a big demon, which doesn't seem worth, or a Baron arm, and then it doesn't become worth it anymore either. So I'll just play a naked module. Now, this is something you don't do too often, but honestly, a naked module or moduling a Harvest Golem, it's not a big difference. The only difference is that the other guy has a Death Rattle, which doesn't matter that much here. I don't think we can ever fit a second Deflect on this board yet. It's not stronger than anything I have currently, and I want to keep my pair. I just want to keep going. And look at this module, by the way. It has 10 attack already. That's why it's worth it, playing naked module sometimes. If you have arm stuff, or if you can't really find a clean way to put it onto something, just play it naked. It's fine. We triple the arm into the Buster, which is what we set up for. So far, life is looking okay. It seems like you might actually have a future this game, because Max need, you know, those extra pieces in order to have a future now, since the Greasebolt nerf. They fell off a little bit and can get out Hyrule, and they lose super hard to Ghoul anyway. Now, this is the Greyable on top again. He has like Goldrin. For some reason, McCaw second trying to like get his Death Rattles off, I guess. He has a Hydra, Bird Buddy, Golden Thump, and yet we win. Surprisingly, since this is probably my worst matchup, you know, matchups that summon a lot of tokens is bad against Max, because Max just have high attack, low HP Divine Shield units, and usually you don't get that much value then. So you're really good against big comps, against like big demons, against Murlocs, against that kind of stuff. Max is really great, because again, you know, lots of high attack Divine Shields, as long as they don't ghoul you. Now Deflectable is worth it, because we do have the Buster. Now I'm valuing whether the arm or the demon is better, but I really think I care more about the high attack. The demon just isn't that relevant anymore, so instead I go with selling that. I do taunt up my Deflecto now, finally, because Deflecto is kind of my smallest unit on the board, and I need attack on it. So by taunting it, we can get more attack value on it with the arm, and more value, more resets as well. Normally, it only guarantees gets one reset, but now we can get two or three, depending on if my taunts die and if it gets attacked into. Here's a guy with double cleave, probably the worst matchup you can face as well. He cleaves in the back, only gets my arm, and then this Four Reaper is also going to go and see where it lands, and it kills my Deflecto bot. But surprisingly enough, spoiler, I'm winning this fight. Even when you think you're in favor and facing someone a lot stronger, or who counters you perfectly with like Ghoul or with Cleaves, Max can always find a way to, you know, turn it in their favor. I think I was just always here with this fight, but even in very unfavored fights, Max can crank up that win percentage if you just get great hits and get like a lot of Deflecto value, if you get some resets, like it's amazing. Now here, I am gonna triple Deflecto because I need a Max now against this big demon player, I think. There is Beast in the lobby. I can also hit another Buster. I might want Deflecto small anyway. I just played it more as a filler card. Hamul sadly didn't give us like anything amazing. It gave us a Mackerel, which is okay. I'm not complaining, but you know, it's not that great. We find Kangers as well. No Baron yet. We are able to turn one of our other cards into a reset as well for this Deflecto. Perfect. And I guess we'll just play the Mackerel. Now, the only thing I'm considering here is the Kangaroos. Is it better than the Mackerel? Is it better than the arm? And after careful consideration, I think that Gengar's is just gonna be better. Like the high attack value, it's probably final fight or two more fights. I think I'd way rather get the spike from Gengar, which I'll put it early, trying to get another full value buster off from it, so I can maybe get more resets onto the deflector if it gets attacked into, scam that way, get a +5/+5 across the board, and see what happens. So far, you know, it's not looking too great. He has a massive taunt and we didn't find any poison. No spore, no maxna. My deflector is not getting any resets, it's just not being attacked into, so we're getting zero value from everything. And you know, Mackerel is awkward for the reason that it's not taunted, so it seems like we might just not get too much value out of it. It just gets one hit. It's kind of like the deflector. I really need to taunt it if I want to be able to make it useful. And he still has his golden doomsayer. This guy is still greeding, and you know, he's gonna get there, because usually big demons is a good matchup. Like I mentioned, high attack divine shields is good against just big bodies, but for some reason he had a bunch of death rattles. He also had like coiler, and that, like I mentioned with the Graybow, is that, you know, summon stuff is good at just bumping my shields, killing my guys with low HP, and then going in for the kill. So sadly enough, we lose this fight. I think there was definitely a way where we could win if we just got some better hits, or at least a little bit of value from this deflector. I'll take a second though. This is a pretty messy game, but this is how you can kind of turn into a tempo mech comp onto your 4 still, even without crease bot, and why you play naked module sometimes, and how you can turn your tank into a unit that also sticks around for a while. Wow. Talking was hard, but I still hope you enjoyed the game. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.